Okay, hello everybody. At least let me say thanks to Daniel and Luis that invited me because I'm very happy to be here and share my project, which is called DesignKit 3.5. But brief summary about me. I'm working in IT 19 years, 10 years as a Java developer. Now I'm working something like Agile Coach and RTE in a big project. And I just developed this plugin to make more sophisticated and very beautiful designs in the Power Apps. So let me just share the history, because the history, it's coming from the 2023, where you can see on the left side, it was a really ugly plugin, but it was able to import JSON and YAML code from the Power Apps. When just time is clocking, then I just moved forward and prepared much more sophisticated plugin and prepared more functionality for the Power Apps. Especially the plugin is helping to canvas applications. So I just put more stuff like the importing for the Power App solutions, something better stuff for the exporting to adding the prefixes. Then I just move forward and just taking care about your theme, like the colors, about your designs of your screens for the Power Apps. And now in 2025, I just put also some for the pasting and copying your YAML snippets for the Power Apps. So how would it works, the architecture for that one? So it's very easy. You need the Figma. If nobody knows the Figma, but I guess a lot of people knows the Figma. It's for a prototyping tool where you can put a lot of designs, business cards, web designs, mobile designs, and here you can run a lot of plugins. So here is my plugin DesignKit, where the backend is close to Azure Functions. We're just checking your license, and then it's very easy. You can import, export for the Power Apps. In this version, it's still included about the Power Automate for importing, but in a new version, 4.0 will be a little bit different because the design will be completely changed and will be really cool stuff for your Canvas applications. Because I decided to have still DesignKit, but it will be called Power Apps for Figma, because I plan the same do it for the Power BI users. So therefore, I decided to change a little bit the style of this plugin. Will be like better for the test environment, so like less defects for the users. More about your styling, changing the colors, backgrounds at once. A lot of exporting. The same for the documentation. You will be able to document the whole project and the Figma and just export for your customer, for your knowledge base. So this is like the architecture for that one. And as I mentioned, will be called Power Apps for Figma. The UI is still like a secret because I plan to release it in August next month, where Houdenc will help me to present in his Power Apps, our podcast, where we present the new style of this Power Apps for Figma plugin. So this is the short intro, and let me just share how the plugin works. So let's start it. When you just run the Figma, doesn't need any paid account for the Figma. You can install it on your desktop, or you can run it through your web browser. So when you start it, you will see a very easy window with some tabs and how it works. The first thing, what you need to read is like the list of the prefixes, because the prefixes is just represent some controls in Power Apps. So it means if you just put like prefix btn underscore and your name, it means it's a button for the Power Apps. The same for a circle, charts, combo box, and other objects. As you see, it's starting to be big controls for your Power Apps controls in your tenant. So therefore, I've already prepared something to do not waste the time. where you have two options. You can start from the free from the scratch. So it means that you can create a new layout, the same like in the Power Apps. You can create the mobile or the tablet layout, some blank or some predefined stuff what Microsoft is offering in the Power Apps. So let's start like the blank for that one. And when you just create the blank layout, you can also put some components. It means like the classic components, what you know from the Power Apps are modern, like avatars, badge, and other components. And plus I put there some compose and custom control. So if you just choose some custom, you can use like, for example, the very popular is feedback box, which is a lot of people are using in the Power Apps. So, and the list of all these crazy components, you can also find in already prepared some cooker, which is for free. You can just be inspired and find a lot of components there. There are a lot of manuals how to make it in Power Apps, how to make it in Figma. So, and I started the new one, Power Apps UI Cooker 2, where it's not too much controls and custom components, but this is fully for free and you can be inspired for your design. Okay, so this is like the first way how you can use it. As you see here, when you create a new screen, will be the prefix, the screen, underscore, and your name. So, and here you can like start to put your components. I've here something prepared. So when I just move it here under the screen, and I see that this is Eisenhower matrix, which is visualizing like here. And now you can just easily to export your selected notes. It means that in last version, you can export the whole screen, or you can only export the component. So this is like in the new version. And when I just export the screen, will be automatically exported to YAML. Just save it. If I just open this YAML code, you can see this is like really the same what Power Apps is using. And if I just open, copy and paste it in a new Power Apps application. So let's wait for the opening. Okay. Loading. Okay, come on. Ah, get bread. And here I just put the paste. So it means that new screen with your Eisenhower matrix is imported here. As you see here, there are the galleries. So it means when you just import here, automatically the sample is imported, but you can just change it for your Dataverse, SharePoint list, doesn't matter. So this is like how can easily copy paste between Figma and the Power Apps. And let me just show you the opposite way, because it's still the easy for the people to move it to the Figma, redesign it and move it back to the Power Apps. So here is some very quick example to share for the some document manager, something like that one. I have already the YAML exported. So when I just go back to Figma, import and find the YAML file here, which I have here. This is the example screen, and just open it, and voila, the UI it's just imported to the Figma. It's not like 100% the same, because Figma properties and Power Apps properties are a little bit different. But when you import something, it's automatically imported the dependency model. It means if you are using some transitions between the screens like the navigate function, then of course it's included during the importing to Figma, and you will see some dependencies for every screen. In the new version, You will be able to export multiple screens. You will be able to make more easy for your design every text colors, every background colors. You can just manage. You will see every control in this plugin, and you can just swap this control or duplicate the whole screen with the unique prefixes. So, and if does not know about still the prefixes and is a little bit hard about that, of course, DesignKit contains the documentation where you can find all information about every functionality of this plugin. Very soon will be updated with the new documentation for the new version, which will be in August next month. And for example, here, I have just here prepared some screen where you can see there is like not too much prefixes. And the plugin, if you do not care about the prefixes, you can just add the prefixes. So just look at the left side. And when I just click add, then automatically the prefixes will be changed and will be just synchronized with the Power Apps controls. And now if I just export again, I can easily just replace it here. So, and I can easily have the whole list of the prefixes for the galleries. And again, I can easily copy and paste it to the Power Apps, and the screen will be here. Only, of course, the images you just need to upload. I have already prepared there, and yeah, before I can replace, and you will have like the same about the font. In the new version, it's already solved. So it means that there is some small issue with this font size, because font size in Figma and font size in Power Apps is a little bit different. So I've already fixed it in the new version, and you will be like totally the same what you importing from Figma to Power Apps. So this is like very easy demo how to use the plugin.